Let me start with the point that Venom is entertaining. But hold on, I said Venom is entertaining. Doesn't mean the movie. Did you get it? Well, let's see how venomous is this movie. Let's find out.
With man and symbiote combined. This is the new race, new species.
Venom is a part of Spider-Man universe, but here, Sony in association with Marvel has created a different universe for this Venom, which has no connection to Spider-Man so far. Tom Hardy is an investigative journalist who is in love with Michelle Williams, a district attorney. Now, due to some unforeseen circumstances, Eddie, aka Tom Hardy, messes up with the head of Life Foundation named Carlton Drake, played by Riz Ahmed, who is adamant to experiment and create something that has come from the outer space. It's called symbiotes. This is where the encounter of Tom Hardy and one of these symbiotes called Venom happens. And they become one. The movie follows the twisted route of Tom Hardy and Venom adjacing to each other and how they defeat the enemies and conquer the world. Director Ruben Fleischer, who is known for movies like Zombieland and Gangster Squad, has done a fair job of keeping the excitement of non-stop adrenaline. I like the fact that just like Spider-Man movies, Ruben kept this one a bit funny. And you enjoy the weird conversations happening between Tom Hardy and Venom. In fact, the way Venom scares Hardy while saying something all of a sudden is a laugh riot. It's a short movie where non-stop action is guaranteed. However, if we keep Tom and Venom's performance aside, along with some action sequences, then there is nothing to praise and enjoy about this movie. This is where the cracks like weak storyline, sketchy supporting cast becomes visible and really don't add much beyond the amazing performance of Tom as a desperate Eddie who's stuck with this Venom and now has to live with it. Climax is also a dull affair where things are moving quite too fast. Another problem is 3D. It has no charm and I suggest you watch it in 2D because this 3D is boring, adds nothing. The makers also shied away from R rating and try to make it a universal kind of a movie to attract a larger audience with PG-13 rating. And I feel this is where the potential of this creature called Venom loses out. Take for reference movies like Wolverine or Deadpool series. They did not shy away from R rating and stayed true to the original shade of the characters. Maybe the idea is to connect Venom universe to the family-friendly Spider universe. In that case, I think it's okay to give PG-13. But I was disappointed. Marvel movies are known for mid-credits, and this one is a real good one, where we see Venom's rival in the making. In the end, this Venom is entertaining but also chaotic, where we get confused than getting consumed. This Venom is a messy fun that you can watch it for once. It was good to see a villain taking over the center stage, and trust me, this one is better than DC's Suicide Squad. It is silly, chaotic, but funny and entertaining at the same time. I'm going out with 7 for this Venom. This is Mad Over Movies. I'll see you very soon. Till then, take care of yourself. Dua mein yaad rakhiyega. Bye.